everyone and welcome back to MATLAB tutorial videos. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about generating random numbers and plotting histograms using inbuilt MATLAB commands. So let's get started. Now, where are random numbers used? They can be used to develop simulations for complex problems, or they can be used to generate a random noise signal for testing and simulating signals. So MathWorks provides us with an inbuilt MATLAB function called random that can be used to generate random numbers. Now this random number generating function uses different random distributions using which it can generate random numbers, for example binomial, uniform, Gaussian, etc. I'm going to show you how you can do that using MATLAB. Let's say we are generating random numbers using exponential distribution. So for that, I'm going to use the function random, which will do that. I'll have to specify the distribution I'm going to use. I'll have to specify the mean around which the random number should be distributed. So let's say in our case it's 3. Also, along with that, I'll have to specify the size of the matrix of random numbers. So let's say in our case it's 1 and 5. So these are the random numbers generated. Another function that can be used to generate random numbers by using uniform distribution and only uniform distribution is randi. Now this function only generates integer type random numbers, and for this function we'll have to specify the range in which the random numbers will be distributed. I'll also have to specify the size of the matrix for which the random numbers will be generated. I'll hit enter and these are the random numbers. So this is how you can generate random numbers using MATLAB. You can use different random distributions and different ranges and means and etc. according to your application. Moving on to histograms. Histograms is a graphical representation of distribution of numerical data. That is, histogram plots frequency of occurrences of different possible outcomes in a continuous data set. Usually histograms are plotted using bar charts. There are different formats that can be used to plot histograms in MATLAB. I'm going to show you three of them. For starters, let's take an example of flipping a coin. So let's say I'm flipping a coin 10 times. The only possible outcomes can be the heads or the tails. Now to represent that in MATLAB, I'm going to represent heads by using 0 and I'm going to represent tails by using 1. Create a set of distributions wherein we'll get the output of coin flipping. So I'm going to call that matrix coin. And I'm going to use randi distribution function which will generate random numbers in the range of 0 and 1, since the only possible outcomes are going to be heads and tails. And let's say I'm flipping a coin 10 times, so the size of the matrix is going to be 1 and 10. This is the output of how the coins are flipped. So there are 5 heads and 5 tails. Now while plotting histogram, sometimes you have to specify the edge of the histogram. In this case, the edges are going to be 0 and 1 as they are the only possible outcomes. So I'm going to specify that using a vector called edge. Apart from this, I'm going to use hist command to separate the numbers of ones in the coin matrix and zeros in the other coin matrix. So edge has stored 5 for 5 heads turn up, another 5 for 5 tails turn up. Now to plot a histogram using bar charts, I'm going to use the command bar, which will plot a bar chart for the histogram H. So this is the output. So this is one way of plotting a histogram plot. Another way of doing the same thing is by using the command histogram itself. Now, while using this command, you'll have to first specify a data set for which the histogram is plot. So for creating the data set, let's say I'm going to name it X. I'm going to use a function rand, which will generate random numbers. And I'm going to specify the size of the matrix X as 1001. So that is my X for which the histogram is going to be plot. So in order to plot histogram, I'm going to use the command histogram, and I'll provide X as the input to that function. So this is the histogram plot for 1000 random numbers that were generated between 0 and 1. Other than this, you can also plot histogram by specifying the number of bins. So let's say I'm generating random numbers and I'm storing it in X. Or let's say 500 counts and one column, so that will be my X, and I'll specify the number of bins as n, which will be equal to, let's say, 35. Now to plot histogram using these two things, I'll provide X and n both as the input, and now you can see the histogram. So let's say you want to plot a histogram for a range of values that lie between minus 6 and 6 when your range of data set goes from minus 10 to 10. So in order to do that, you'll have to first generate a data set which will go from minus 10 to 10, and the size of the matrix X will be, let's say, 501. So for this data set, you just have to plot the histogram for the range minus 6 to 6. In order to do that, you'll have to specify the edge of along which your histogram is going to be plot. So I'm going to do that by using this command. So that will be my vector edge. So to plot histogram, I'm going to use the command histogram, and I'm going to provide both X and edge to the input of the histogram. And the histogram is plot for the values ranging from minus 6 to 6, and this is the bin area specified by the edges. So this is how it looks like. So that is how you plot histogram in MATLAB. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button or subscribe if you want to keep yourself updated with our channel. If you have any queries, please feel free to post it in the comment sections. And of course, don't forget to leave your suggestions for the topics you find difficult to understand or you find it difficult to implement in MATLAB, and we will do it for you. So that's all. I'm going to sign off. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.